Alright, this is Bill and Tanya at the Peach.
Fuck it.
What are you doing?
I'm all over the place.
This is Bill and Tanya at the Peach Orchard. Estes Method. Tanya's moving around, getting comfy. Is there anybody here with us?
Call Mom.
I need your name first. Can you give me your name?
There was something, but I couldn't tell what it was. Help me.
I'd like to help you, but I need your name first. I gotta know who I'm talking to.
Maybe.
We can talk a little bit before you give me your name.
I'm falling.
You're falling? Were you falling after you got shot? I'm assuming I'm talking to a soldier. Were you Union or Confederate? We would just like to talk to you. Get to hear your story a little bit.
Kneel down.
Well, I can't kneel down. I'm inside my truck. I'd really like your name.
Yep. And that was a southern voice. Yep.
All right, so you're a good old boy from the south. I get that. Sir, may I have your name? Sir, out by that tree, I placed a little box that has some green on it. There's a piece of metal sticking out of the top of it. If you touch it, so it'll light up and make a little bit of noise. Can you do that for me?
You lie.
I'm not lying. It's out there. I just put it there. But if I see it light up, I'll know that you're here and that you can hear me. But you gotta really grab onto it so those lights get bright.
You scare me.
I'm sorry.
Excuse me.
I don't mean to scare you. My name is Bill. This here is Tanya. We just want to talk.
That girl.
Yeah, that girl's Tanya. She can hear what you say, and she'll tell
me. Be cool. You're welcome.
So if you talk to her, she can hear you, and she'll tell me what you say.
I'm bored. I'm bored. Fuck you.
Now that's just not nice. There's a lady present. Watch your language.
What are you doing?
Just want to talk to you, man. Just want to talk. So please. Nope.
I didn't kill nobody.
Okay.
Easy.
I didn't say that you did kill anyone. I made an assumption that you weren't a soldier. If you weren't, that's okay.
What are you doing?
Just talking to you. I'm just trying to understand who you are.
I didn't. I'm moving. What was that?
Is there more than one person here with me? Can I get your name, please? Is there anybody still here with us?
And?
Are you done talking to us? Do you want us to leave?
Coffee.
I'm sorry, I don't have any coffee for you. I can bring that next time we come. But only if you tell me your name.
You're right. That man.
Are you talking about me or somebody else?
Hey, man.
Do you want to keep...
Boston.
Are you from Boston? So you're a Yankee then?
Copperfield.
Is that your last name? Copperfield?
Dear God.
Mr. Copperfield, can you tell me your first name? Mr. Copperfield, if you go out by that tree, touch that little box that has the green on it, it'll light up and make some noise. Can you do that for me?
Move over.
No, I'm not going to move over. I either want your first name or I want you to touch that box, one or the other. After that, then you could request something of me.
Thank you.
Well, don't thank me yet. You need to touch that box first. Or give me your first name.
I'm not lying to you.
I'm not accusing you of lying. I just want to know your first name.
Bloody something.
Look, I'm not asking for much from you. Do you not want to talk
to
us?
Good morning.
It's not morning.
Recording.
I am recording. I'm recording your voice.
Careful. Radio. A little one.
So yes, I'm recording. You're able to speak through the radio. Tanya can hear you.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. Mr. Copperfield, are you leaving?
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I love you.
Well, I guess I love you too. I just don't know who you are.
You got it quick? What?
What?
What just happened?
I just checked my phone.
Oh.
It started buzzing.
I thought you were tapping like... to get my attention.
No, I'm sorry.
Anything?
Yeah. Yeah, there
was... You did?
Yeah, there was a, southern gentleman. Well, he was a southern guy. He was no gentleman. He came through. He wouldn't tell me his name. He answered a few questions. And then he yelled, "Fuck you." Well, so he asked, what did he say? Oh, I introduced myself.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I introduced myself. I introduced you.
Uh-huh.
He says, the lady said, yes, this is Tanya. She can hear you speak if you talk through her. And then he yelled, "Fuck you." And I yelled back, "Hey, there's a lady present. Watch your language."
Mm-hmm.
That's unacceptable. And then it sounded like he got in an argument with somebody else, saying that he didn't shoot them. He's not a murderer.
I'm not lying.
I'm not lying.
That came across like twice.
Yeah.
I'm not lying.
But it started to sound like the two people were going back and forth at it.
I was going to say, it sounded like southern voices, y'all.
After the arguing, somebody else came through. He said he was from Boston. So I said, "Oh, I'm assuming you're a Yankee then. What's your name?" "Copperfield." I said, "All right, Mr. Copperfield, can you give me your first name?" He would not give me his first name. So I started asking, you know, him to, you know, go touch that, give me your first name, give me something so I know who I'm talking to.
Mm-hmm.
And he says, "Kneel down." I said, "I'm not kneeling down. I'm inside my truck. Before you can tell me what to do, you need to either go out and touch that so I know you're here, or tell me your first name, and then you could ask me to do something."
Mm-hmm.
And he said, "I'm bored." And I'm sorry.
No, that was said on board.
On board.
Yeah, I know, because I thought it said, I corrected myself. I remember that part. on board, not I'm bored. Okay. On board.
But then it sounded like he was talking to somebody else again for a little bit. And then said goodbye. The end. I said, oh, are you done talking? Are you leaving now? Mr. Copperfield, I'd like to know more about you still, but if you need to go, I understand. And then my phone went off and you came out.
No one did the light?
No one did the light.
Want to try some rope?